Jumbo guys, let us go back in time to the St. Petersburg Open that was held in 1993. White pieces being Grigory Sapa or Greg, and black Ioannis Nikolaidis. Greg learned chess at the age of 6 years from his grandfather, and at the age of 16 he started studies at Moscow's famous Botvinnik Kasparov Chess School. In 1988 he attended the 27th World Junior Chess Championship that was held in Australia and took the third place, and in 1992 he won the silver medal in the 30th Chess Olympiad. Nikolaidis, on the other hand, won the Greek Chess Championship in 1995. He played for Greece in the Chess Olympiads of 1994, 1996, 1998, 2000, 2002, 2004, and 2006. This game is famously known as the Immortal Sacrifice Exchange Game, where White sacrificed all his pieces, excluding the king. Greg calls this game my personal Mona Lisa. Okay, let's go into the game. White started with c4. Then black replied with g6. e4, bishop g7, d4, d6, knight c3, knight f6, going for the king's Indian defense. Knight g to e2, knight bd7, knight g3, c6, bishop e2, a6, bishop e3, h5, f3, some kind of the same-ish variation. b5 was played by Nikolaidis. Black is playing on the sides of the board. c5 was played by Greg. a3 is also a move to be considered. Then after b takes c4, bishop takes c4, then d5, an equal position. So after c5, Nikolaidis took on c5, then d takes on c5, queen c7, white castled, h4, forcing the knight to retreat to h1, the only move. Knight h5, with the idea of bishop taking on c3, doubling the white pawn, or bishop to e5, eyeing on the h2 pawn. Queen d2, stopping black's plan. If bishop e5, then f4. So after queen d2, e5 was played by Nikolaidis. Knight f2, rerouting the knight to a better square. Knight f8 was played, with the intention of playing knight e6, or even bishop e6. Instead of knight f8, knight f4 is also a move to be considered. Then white will continue with knight to d3, then after bishop h6, f4, going for the breakthrough. F4 was played anyway. B4 was a reply by Nikolaidis. Pause the video and find the move that Greg played. Okay, here's the move. Knight to d5, going to the enemy's camp, intending to play knight to b6. Black took on d5, and white replied with e takes e5. And now, white has the idea of knight to e4, followed by knight to d6. Or c6, followed by rook to c1. Another move that is playable is d6. So black replied with the capture on d5 with f5, still playing on the sides of the board. d6 came. Queen c6 was the reply to d6. If, then c6. Queen takes c6, rook c1, followed by rook c7. After queen c6, white played another surprising move. Pause the video and find it. The move is none other than bishop b5, pinning the queen to the king. a takes b5 is pretty much forced. a takes b5, queen takes b5. Some moves like queen to b7, here comes c6, Then after queen b8, b6, and these three musketeers should frighten you. Instead of queen b8, if queen takes on b5, then d7 check with the rook on a8 hanging. So black decided to capture on b5. Rook takes on a8. Queen c6, attacking the rook on a8. Rook fa1, doubling the rooks. f4 was played by black, trapping the bishop. What would you have played as white in this position? Pause the video and find the move. Rook a7, allowing black to capture the bishop. Knight d7 was played by black. What would you have played if black would have captured the bishop? Pause the video and find the move. Taking the bishop on a3 loses tactically because of queen d5. So after knight to d7, an excellent sacrifice occurred on the board. Rook takes d8, check. Queen takes d8, queen d5, and black decided to capture the bishop. Knight f6 was to be considered. Queen e6 check, king f8 the only move. If king d8, there's a mate in one. King e7 checkmate. Knight e4, with the idea of taking the knight to g5 and threaten a mate on f7. So if black would have decided to capture the bishop with f takes on e3, then knight g5, then after queen e8 defending the mate, then rook a8 followed by mate and the next move. So if knight takes on e4, then rook takes on f7, queen e8, rook e7, with white having the winning position. So instead, queen e8 is much better. After queen takes on e8, knight takes on e8 is pretty much forced, because if king takes, rook a8 check, king f7, knight g5 is actually a mate. So after knight e8, rook takes on d7, f takes on e3, c6 with a winning position for white. Back to the game. Black decided to capture on e3, then queen e6 check. King f8 is forced. King d8 loses to queen e7 checkmate. Rook takes on d7. F takes on e2 check. King h1, a very important move. Capturing the pawn will give black the initiative and possibly a mate. So after king f1, queen e7. Some moves such as queen a6 check, king takes on f2, then queen e2 is a very nice tactical move. Because after king takes on e2, knight f4 check, king f1, knight e6, instead of queen a6, knight g3 is also a nice try. After h takes on g3, queen takes on d7, queen takes d7, h takes g3 with the idea of rook h1 check, followed by promoting. So queen e7 is forced. After king g8, queen e8 check, king h7. If bishop f8, then queen g6, bishop g7, queen takes g3, then d7. Back to the game. Queen e8. Here came another sacrifice by white. Rook f7 check. Taking on e8 is also playable. After king takes on e8, rook e7 check. If black decides to go to king d7, then c6. Menacing rook a7, followed by rook a8 checkmate. So king c8 is pretty much forced. Rook a7 anyway, king b8, d7. After king takes on a7, then c7. So instead of king d7, if king f8, then c6, knight to g3 check, king f2,
Taking on g3 will lead to h takes on g3. Then after king e2, rook h1, followed by promotion. So after king capturing on f2, knight f5, white still having the winning position. So after the sacrifice on f7, check. Queen f7. Queen c8, check. Queen e8. It was Aaron Nimzowitsch who said that a passed pawn is a criminal that should be kept under lock. Mild measures such as police surveillance are not sufficient. So in this position, White decided to push his D criminal. King f7, and now the D criminal is now a royal terrorist. Black captured on e8. Queen b7, check. Rook e7, and now comes the C criminal. e4 was played by Black. What would you have played as White in this position? Pause the video and find the move. F takes e4 is a mistake because of rook takes b7. After c takes b7, bishop e5. The correct move after e4 is c7. e3 was played by Black. Pause the video and find the correct move played by White. Promoting the C criminal into a royal terrorist is a mistake because of e2 check. King takes on f2, then Black promotes with a checkmate. So the correct move is queen d5 check. King f6 was played by Black. King d6 check. King f7. Queen d5 check. King f6. Queen d6 check. King f7. White decided to repeat these moves to get to move 40 because he was under time pressure. So after king f7, White captured on e7 check. King takes c7. Then White promoted. Bishop h6 was played by Black. Another move like bishop to d4 would have been met by queen to c4 or queen to g4. So after bishop h6, queen c5 check, king e8. If king f7, then queen c4 check. After king e8, queen b5 check. King d8, queen b6 check. King d7, queen takes g6. Black, with his dying kicks of a horse, played e2 check. Taking on e2 is a mistake because of knight f4 check, forking the king and the queen. So White captured on f2. Bishop e3 check. King e1. Capturing on e3 is a mistake because Black promotes a check. So after king e1, Black resigned. He had received enough beating. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment on this video. See you in the next one. Bye.